Michael O'Leary, of course, is the Jiggins Town House stud boss. And Apple's Jade coming up against Nichols. Can you got to get a bit of weight and you've got to run, so you'll be hoping for every chance of beating the stairs hurdle here?
I suspect not. The ground is heavy. You know, I think it'll favour the stair, and Nichols Canyon is as tough as old boots.
You always like this, Michael, aren't you? You're always a bit depressing.
I'm generally pessimistic, yeah. So I'm usually right.
Would she be one that would definitely be aimed at the mare's hurdle, or is she a mare that you could just chuck her in the champion hurdle and see how she does?
Too far away. Yeah, planning here in the middle of the first week of December for what the hell's going to Cheltenham.
Planning is everything, Michael. Is maybe one or two people might say you should have learned this. Yeah,
that is true. I'm learning that as I go along.
Do the Irish authorities listen to someone like you if you say to them, you know, everything should be levels, or do they just do what they want?
No, they've far too much common sense to listen to an idiot like me. They spend more time listening to you than they do listening to me, but you might talk a modicum of sense occasionally, whereas I never talk sense. I'm always talking rubbish.
There's an element of truth in everything you've just said, I think.
There is.
And if you've got one horse that everyone is eulogising about, the next on Cossack, Samcro. I mean, I know you're a pessimist, but even you must be getting a little bit jiggy about him.
No, I mean, like, the
yes,
hype,
you are. Come
the
on.
The hype at Samcro is rubbish. Like, look, he's won his maiden hurdle. He won a graded hurdle, you know, reasonably well. Dead Duty did the same last year, went to Cheltenham and blew up. You know, so all this hype is, you know, to
deceive. What would he have to do, Michael, for you to be excited by him?
He'd have to go to Cheltenham and actually win a race there. And the rest of it is all just anti-Bose hype to delude anti-post punters betting this time of the year. He is not as good as the hype would make out. He will never be as good as the hype will make out. And if he turns out to be a reasonable good chaser in time, great. But he's not the next coming of Jesus Christ.
Well, we know that's Willie Mullins, and you don't want
that's
him, do you?
Oh, I want him. I just can't afford him.
He really is a special horse, and I know you don't like to hype them, but that was special, Michael.
It was a very good performance in what was probably a very good race, but, you know, he has done no more than hopefully we would have expected him to do, but he's still not Jesus Christ. He will be when he wins, hopefully, a chase, a proper race.
Is there any chance of you going back to God at some stage?
Of course. As ever, as soon as we could reach an agreement on fees, I'd be back there like a shot.
Do you ever talk about it?
We always talk about it. I mean, every time I meet Willie, we talk about it. But, you know, he's immovable object. I'm irresistible force, and he's immovable object. So, look, we keep trying.
Because Bram would think he probably has every chance of taking your cash on Fox Norton and maybe in the Ryanair.
Well, I've been second in it about seven times, so I can't bloody well get my own cash back, but I'll keep trying.
It's been an interesting year for Ryanair, hasn't it?
Has. We're having a great year up until about the middle of September, and then we messed up the pilot rosters, but we fixed it.
So what, you basically, a lot of people were on holiday when they shouldn't be, or?
No, a lot of people were allocated holidays when ultimately they have to. It was just we screwed up. We fixed it back in September, but we fixed it at some cost to ourselves and some pain. But I think it goes to show that, it confirms what everybody has always believed, that really I don't walk on water. I'm a pretty average manager and make lots of mistakes. Humility is a very good thing in a human being, Matt. You should try it occasionally.
If you head back to Willie Mullins, maybe he can help you walk on some water and teach you what God's really like.
No, Willie walks on water. Willie and Gordon, they both walk on water.
Your two boys are watching you like Jack's thinking, geez, boss, don't say, and Davey's saying, oh my God, he's going to take Matt for a cup of tea. Look, have a good day.
All right, you too.
This might be a moment for me to take you for a cup of tea. On behalf of racing fans, can I suggest to you that after Super Sunday won yesterday, Apple's Jade is far too good to be running in the Mayor's Hurdle, a race that none of us did to. You couldn't even care if she wins another Mayor's Hurdle. Why won't you do the right thing for the sport and put her in the two championship races?
Because she's a mare and she belongs in the Mayor's Hurdle.
Let Flaky Dove was a mare, Dawn Run was a mare, and they became legends of the... Don't you want a legend of the turf?
I'd be very happy on the first day in Cheltenham to win the Mayor's Hurdle. And if you have a horse good enough to win the Mayor's Hurdle, go in the Mayor's Hurdle.
Wouldn't you rather win the stairs or the champion?
I couldn't care less about the stairs, and she's not fast enough to win the champion. So let her go in the Mayor's Hurdle. I think that's where she'll go.
Is there nothing anyone with sense can say to you to make you change your mind?
It's not. Look, this is a team effort, so Eddie and Gordon will ultimately decide. But right. I see no reason not to go in the Mayor's Hurdle. I mean, she'll be up. She'll be
the good of the sport.
She'll be good of the sport. Look, I lose enough money every year for the good of this sport. I want winners in Cheltenham, and if I could win the Mayor's, so if you told me now she'll win the Grey's Hurdle, that's where she's going.
Oh. Such a disappointment.
Don't
Michael.
Worry. Life such is full of disappointments, man.
Generally, I think they'll fall at the last fence.
Well, it was a hurdle race anyway, so you were right there. But
right, we call them fences over here, Matt. don't get technical with
well,
me now.
Well, you know, technical things are the way you've had problems.
You're skating now and we stay loyal to racing.
You are a horrible individual. But Gordon Elliott, he's already provided you with a gold cup, though, and I know you hold him in, obviously, the highest regard. You think he's really special?
I don't. I think he's somewhat overweight. Right. Not as good-looking as me, but, you know, right. He's better training horses than I am, to be fair. I'm thinking of getting him into roster a couple of pilots, sort out a few of the other issues.
And so let's just get this absolute, Michael. No, let's make this clear. Hold on. Samcro's not special. Gordon's no. overweight. Yes. Jack is one of many. I'm beginning to see why the pilots didn't turn up. Have a nice day, Michael.
That's a low blow.